Hello, boys, and welcome to SFX Zero Profile Production and the next part of Rising Angels Reborn. So, I really saw the like Surimo now and then she opening up. Start recording right here. Load. Suri flips through the pictures of her homeworld without a second of nostalgia. Can we blame her? The dry world seems pretty bland. One picture of what I think is room in the wall catches my eye. What is that one? I don't know. Graffiti of some sort? Who knows? Who cares? The glowing blue scribbles look really familiar though, as does the person standing beside it. He's not a dreamer. He looks more like a human researcher. Oh, I think I know. I don't remember taking this one. Negis must have. He always liked to take those weird scenery pictures. No, I don't think so, Suri. When we were breaking out that underground datapad, did we see a picture that looked just like this? Those markings look like the runes. Hey, wait! You gave me this picture! Remember? You were clutching yours so tight that I couldn't see it, so you gave me a copy. I did? I didn't? I... To the lab. And I'm still... Make copies of that picture then. I'm going to get Rasuna to let you out of this cage. No, take it. You need to get cracking on this now. You're right, but I think I'm done remisking for now. As long as you bail me out or after you're done, you can borrow it. Nothing bad is going to happen to this one, I give you my word. That's good enough for me. Now go shoot. And Suri, let's keep this secret for now. Alright. I'm not going to risk my adversary getting a step ahead of me. I'm once again in the lead of the operation, I have the truth in my hands. But as I walk out, I can see that forlorn look returns Suri's face. I'm going to get her out of this cage. She might want to protect others, but I do as well. I can't believe it, I got my clue back. Maybe not all of them, but at least I have something to validate my existence. My lab door is unlocked again. Now I'm positive I locked it last night. Well, my crew came back to me and the culprit returning to the scene of crime. Today is a good day. Aha! I caught you! Could not yell so loud. I can hear you for perfectly fine without the volume increase. Giga? I should have known. Perhaps because we met before and I told you my name. What's wrong with you? What's wrong with me? How did you get into my lab? The door. Was it unlocked when you got here? No. So you broke into my lab? That's a question that you can answer without an attitude. This is why we need to go home. Rice isn't good for your temperament. You are going to explain how you unlocked my door and what the hell you are doing in here, and I want answers now. Not in a week. You seem perfectly content on making us wait with no information for that long. She dodging my question, left and right. Still, she can't leave this lab without getting past me. I will get my answers. Whatever, spy. I got what I wanted anyway. And whatever is this and leaving here. Unless you can pry my brain out, too bad. I wanted the truth for myself and I found it. You're not seriously going to pry my brain out. That's a murder, in case you forgot, idiot. Where is the recording? Your precious recording is is on the table. I didn't break it like Suri did. Suri didn't break anything. Someone else did. Of course, Suri broke it. Stop lying to yourself. The evidence all points to her. Oh, is that it? You think I broke it? You broke into my lab and and are avoiding simple inquiries about your methods and your purpose. Yeah, I'm a bit suspicious. I don't have to explain myself to you. Yes, you do. Fine, I know you were been holding information from us, like the real wording of the recording. I came in here to do a little investigation on my own, without my permission. No? You idiot, really? Why would you ask me permission from a person suspected of hiding critical details? Because those details are above your clearance. If I choose not to share them, that's my prerogative. That's how you kill people. I bet you know about those monsters in the sand. You crossed the line, Lieutenant. Do you think I put you all in danger without a proper warning? You see, are all alike. Ford used to tell me stories about the corruption in the organization. I'm starting to see you are the same. My temper is flaring and I can see the ripped paper in my mind. To think I felt bad for the girl just a few days ago. Your hunger is getting better of you. Start minding your... What does it matter? You're going to kill us. You almost killed Freya and you haven't shown a single bit of remorse. How was I supposed to know that they were walking into a pack of sand piranhas? By doing your job. I did my job. I'm sure you did. With these clues, I'm starting to see what your job really is. What are you going to do when we find this thing? Are you going to just hand it over or are you going to use it? Are you going to keep it for your own purpose? Nothing to defend yourself? I'm trying to understand how you could possibly be this dense. I've been honest since the start. You haven't bothered telling me what I want to know. It sucks when the shoe is on the other foot, doesn't it? Except I can have you court-martialed for disturbing my operation. For keeping the rest of the crew informed of what you are doing. Just because the commander chose not to share my reports with you doesn't mean I'm trying to kill anyone. But fine. Court-martial me, Major. I will. What? Go ahead, do it. Are you trying to challenge me? Yep, do it. Why can't she just go ahead and apologize for her disturbance? Why does she want to make this a fight? A cop breaking into my lab. End of the story. If she thinks I'm unafraid to bring any sort of secret into the light, Lieutenant Starr is surely mistaken. There is nothing. I take her back to and have her stripped of her rank. Wait. Nice try. We're not going home. You're not as dumb as you look. Why are you so bent on ending this search for a potential war-destroying artifact? Do you not care? I care a hell of a lot more than you do. Which is why I want to leave the stupid thing lost. The researchers are clearly trying to lose it in an uncharted space. Why don't we let them? Actually, I didn't think we would going back. Actually, I thought she would be locked in her room until all of this investigation was ended. Do you think someone else is going to get it for us? Yeah. The voids of space. My brother's boiling. She deserves to be locked up in the room far away from a place where she could interfere with my operation. This delinquency is unacceptable. Oh, and idiotically. Kayla let me in. Everyone wants to know the truth of what's hiding from us. Kayla, let her in. But why? She doesn't strike me as the type who would want to break rules. Unprofessional, but clean and squeaky. So support her. My dear, you must let the curious lieutenant bother you so. Oh, Colony Nelson, can you help me with something? I would like to extend my hand for you, to you, if you wouldn't mind. We would? That's right, we would. I think I had enough of a fight with the officer. Help me, Officer Midi. Did you, Leader Grand Lieutenant, saw access to my lab? I need an answer. Triasamad, I just keep the bitterness out of my stone. This operation didn't need any more Rensha Shokdon. It's alright, little one. Just tell her exactly what you told me. No, you must be brave or you will be the one who is punished. Kika forced me. She threatened to hurt me if I didn't help her. That's not conducted as a self-proclaimed hero. That's sick and disgusting. What about when you my datapad got destroyed? Did you let her in then as well? I racked my brain for some evidence to counter this statement. It seems a legitimate for the trembling hands of a frightened bunny rabbit look. But it seems too convenient. Kika had no alibi for the first event. Her sore attitude and clear attempts at forcing an early termination to this mission don't do much to clear her name. Still, Kylie didn't have an alibi either, as enraged at Lieutenant Star conducted some right emotional should convict her. This could be a situation of the bad Kurtmetenses. Do I trust the hostile Kitsune who just lost her family, or a adorable mechanic who has even soul support, even though she's under the wings of an corrupted officer? I'll look into it. There's something suspicious with Kylie anyway. I think she may have known more about the attack and the destiny than she's letting on. She did have a very nasty fight with our sweet Faye as soon as Faye woke up.
Really?
Oh yes, quite nasty. Their relationship has been strained for a very long time. Perhaps Faye grew tired of being the Kitsune's minion. Faye never seemed too happy with the title. The pale-haired Lupina always strikes me as more of a lone wolf. All the more reason I need to talk with Faye. Could Kika be looking to the score of revenge? That would be her motive as an unverified one. But a potential motive for working with the well teens. But they'd need time to develop a relationship. Who laid that trap had been working closely with their well teens for a while. What does why doesn't it fit Kika with some more evidence? Is something the matter? No, I was thinking. Perhaps you should take a break. You don't wish to get the premature wrinkles in those lovely cheeks of yours, do you? He's right, Mayor. You're really pretty. Thanks, you're adorable yourself, Officer Midi. What do you say? We have barely had a chance to talk since you arrived. Well, enjoy his flattery. I have a mission and a chance to a lifetime. I don't know what a dark future awaits me, my clue, so I need to be hasty. I'm afraid not. I can't say busy. He pried the question what I'm up to. If he is the culprit, he'll try to raid my lab. If he isn't, he could spill the beans to my other suspects, Kika. What would you say if I offered you a nice juicy steak instead of that dry rice you had for dinner? You look quite famished, if you don't mind me saying so.
You have what?
Surely you grow weary of meager rice and limited amounts of sun food. Would you not care to partake in a real meal with myself and my little friend? The colonel cooks really good food, Natalie. Join us. But aren't we rationing food right now? I don't really recall seeing anything of the sort on the menu. Of course you wouldn't. We wouldn't have it if it were so we're stealing from the ship's stores.
No.
They just never made it into the inventory sheet. Nobody will miss them. Except for you if you refuse the generous offer. Come. You will use a good meal. Is that what happened to the medicine cat and Moonfall needed? It just never made it off to the official numbers. I don't know what you're talking about, my dear. Little Feya got her medicine and is recovering from that venom. Yeah, the venom. Don't tip your hand, Natalie. You can't trust him. He's just as suspect as Kika right now. More so since Kika seems to be at least have positive motives. You expect me to turn a blind eye to this in exchange for food? I expect nothing. I would not offer this to you if I didn't think you were an amusito. So it is a bribe for what? Bribe in such a nasty world. We just want to be your friend. It was my idea. He wanted to spend some time hanging out and I thought this would be a good present to break the ice. It's very rude to turn down a gift. Please don't you join us. I got to go visit Feya. I can't stay for a meal. That's alright. We brought our gift with us, Kylie. Kylie extends a small counter full of cube steak bits. The meat is based in the herbs and what I assume is steak sauce of some kind. My stomach gurgles in the anticipation. But to accept a bribe, I swore when I started this to be an officer who has morals. I can't swing my stand when my stomach dictates. I have my pride and honor to think about. Maybe some other seater would take it. But I'm an officer with a sense of pride in her duty. I must align this. There are government goods, especially when we are rationing. It's wrong. But nothing. If I want to give a gift, you would take that you have and put it in the ship's stores. After all, the praises from Seoul is expect better for you. I'm sorry. I turn to show out the colonel for this part in this, but I stop short when I see the icy glare and sick smile on his face, his predatory ready to strike. I'm sorry, Kelly, my dear. Why? You intended to report this, don't you, Major? Your honor dictates it. That's right. Then I'm very sorry, my compassion mechanic. Why? Because your sweet gift to the Major is technically fraud and theft. You've been stealing from the state and smuggling in unauthorized goods aboard a military craft. The Cadillac Space Force highly frowns upon that, even if you did it with the best intentions. But? No buts. I'm afraid what you have done is highly illegal. When Natalie reports you could be looking at years in maximum prison. But everyone was so happy. I was doing good for everyone. I know, my sweet girl. But those who follow the rules do not have compassion for those who would break them, even if for the best of reason. That's the reason. Everyone else is suffering. Is everyone? It pains me to say, but I think everyone on the ship has profited from Kali's smuggling. What are you treasuring? Oh no, threat. I'm just stating that should our young Hoban go to Yale, others might be investigated as well. I know one person on the ship loved receiving gifts of Quinn's steaks from Kylie. The investigation might put more that one person in jail. That bastard. Please, I don't want to go to jail. I just wanted to help people. Everyone was so happy. They were happy, Kylie. They were. And then still can't be. It isn't that right, Major Pusselin. Put the blame on Kylie and send Seoul to prison. To the right thing and put an honest officer in prison for doing nothing more than thinking his quartermaster was on the level. Seoul isn't the only one either. Surrey, Alpenas, and the others. Fine, you bastard. Keep quiet. Tut tut, that's not good attitude you have. Here, I have some steak for to cheer you up. Major, over a little. The major was just overreacting. She is not going to send you to Yale and will be happy to have your gift. Really? Let's get back to our lab. I promise to spend some special time with you. Heh, bye! I couldn't send Seoul to prison. He looks out for me, and I look out for him. We are a team, but I should have. My job means I have to do things like this. I can't even do this one simple job right. Those idiots back at the academy are probably laughing their heads off right now. I should never have allowed emotion to get my acquaintance. But I was happier here. I don't want to keep my distance. Alright, sorry, Yostar, that's what I say. Pretty funny. When you hit X and not quit on the second project games, the quit screen comes up anyway. Pretty funny. But at least that was all I had for Rising Angels Reborn this time, but hit like and subscribe. And I see you next time. Profile!